the difference between a certificate and a certified copy of the birth. Now, why must you be a secure party creditor? So you must realize without being a secure party creditor, you will not be able to fulfill most of the remedies mentioned in the discharging process and court procedures, child support cases, set-offs, or standing in commerce in general. You will not get your commercial redemption without being a secure party creditor. Your birth certificate bond if you begin your path on to redemption, that's the first step, is that birth certificate bond. It's the contract from which all other contracts come from. That's the meat and the potatoes of all that you do afterwards. Now, if you want a simple explanation of how important it is, I'll give it to you. If you enter a courtroom, watch this. I'm going to show you why you got to be a secure party creditor. And all this consumer credit nonsense is not going to really bring you the benefits of a secure party creditor. All of the equity law is not going to save you. If you're in a courtroom, unbonded, you stand little to no chance. The minute you step into that court territory, you're in contempt. A damn bill of exchange is not going to help you. Consumer law is not going to help you. Equity is not going to help you. If you're not a secure party creditor and you don't have a lien against that debtor, you just stepped into contempt. I'm not saying you can't win, but I'm saying you're entering as a debtor. If all you're going off is consumer credit, you're a damn debtor. If all you're going off is equity, you are a debtor. And that's what slavery really is. You understand? I'm not saying you can't win. You're going in as a debtor. And if you enter a court unbinded, you're already in contempt of court. I know this is going on some of your heads. Get Kahan Tazadok's books. Get the new one. Electronic Funds Transfer. Get that book. And get The Game of Commerce and How to Play It. Or Freedom for Behind Bars. And get Emasculation of Nations. Because I go into this stuff in deep explanation. So if you enter a courtroom unbinded, you're already in contempt of court. Why? Why, Tazadok? What are you talking about? Enlighten us. Because you have entered a place of business, Mr. Jonah Bay, a place of commerce, and you are not insured to operate. Being a secure party creditor insures you to operate. So you are operating in a position that is very difficult to rise from if you go in as a debtor. Now, let's not forget that if you are not binded, you cannot start down the road of identifying yourself as a creditor. A consumer is not no damn creditor. Go and look up the word consumer. Dealing with equity doesn't make you a creditor. Colin tells a doc up in lower case. Tukahan Tazadok, all capital letters, which is a legal fiction, your vessel that sells in commerce. Yeah. You can file a UCC-1 or equivalent, but is that enough? No. You got to become a secure party creditor. Do you understand? Redeem the birth certificate. See, the birth certificate bonds explains the certificate of registration of live birth by banking definition, right? A certificate when we look at the certificate of live birth, by banking definition, it's a certified security. The application they made was known as an application for live birth, right? Application for live birth certificate. And what was issued from this application was known as a birth certificate. The company, the United States, kept the original application and gave your parents a copy of a certificate. Now, I just explained what a certificate was. There's no real gain, therefore no income. Therefore, no income taxes. The application that they made was known as an application for a live birth certificate. And that was issued from the application that was known as a birth certificate. This created what is known as a foreign citizens trust account. Also, when filled out, the SS-5, you allow the company access to your account. It's kind of like a checkbook, huh? That was prepaid. It's a prepaid account that was set up when the birth certificate was issued. You permitted them as signers to write checks on your account. And they do it all the time, people. Keep in mind, this is the same account that the bankers fractionalized, created huge, almost unlimited sums of money. And we became co-business partners with that company. We permitted them as signers to write checks on our accounts. And they do it all the time. All the time. Almost unlimited sums of money. They can access and use our prepaid accounts for whatever they deem necessary. The company took the application and pledged your future laborer as a guarantee for payment to the bankers, also known as the International Monetary Fund, the IMF. The bankers gave the company a credit for your application against the account that the company owned, the bankers, which is at the time of your birth, was worth close to $1 million. This transaction is what is referred to as a money of account. The transaction, as no real money has really changed hands, so it's a money of an account. So in layman's term, it's really an accounting entry against the debt owed to the bankers by the company. It's clear deception. The bankers then took your application and used fractional banking lending. See, it's the birth certificate that is proof that an application was submitted. You know what I told you? It is the application that is the real negotiable instrument, and the birth certificate proves there is a negotiable instrument being used in commerce to borrow money. You say what? Tell the doc. Number 8230, fractional banking. If your birth certificate is worth $1 million at birth, the bank could loan that same $1 million as many as 9 times, thus making your birth certificate worth $9 million. And keep going and keep going. But what if I told you you could redeem that birth certificate and get your title back? How do you do it? You do it by becoming a secured party creditor. See, right now, even though they have no legal right or claim or lien, the bankers control your title. The birth certificate is the title. See, you're the only one who could actually go to the bank and redeem and regain control of the birth certificate, just like a car. The car gives value to the title to the car. You give value to the title to your birth certificate. See, without you, the birth certificate is worthless. It's worthless. A lot of people say you go out and you authenticate the birth certificate. Gives you control. That's not enough. You got to become a secure party creditor. See, when you receive your authentication from the U.S. Department of State, your actions establish you as a creditor. But it doesn't relieve you from all the other contracts. Secure party creditor process makes you without the United States, a foreign country. See, when a document is used in a foreign country, it may be necessary to have the document authenticated. That's why you authenticate your birth certificate. Huh? Back in the day, we were telling people to get apostilles and all of that. Well, now, what I would like to do now, I'm going to share my screen and I'm going to show you that the birth certificate really exists. And this is why you need to be a secure party creditor. The consumer credit, the equity law, none of that is going to get you out of this. I'm going to give you the steps. And we're going to go to Fidelity. But I'm going to try and talk you through it. They've changed the site up because I looked at it this morning. We're going to show you that this exists. This is Cajon Tazadoc's process on how to look up a birth certificate, court case, SSN, or whatever. So you're going to go to fidelity.com. We're here. Huh? This is how you can look up a birth certificate, bond, or court case, Social Security, what have you, right? So you would need any court case numbers for any active cases that you have, or the Social Security card of your corporate citizenship status, United States citizen, in other words, and a copy of your birth certificate. So we go to fidelity.com. Let me drop the link in the room. That's why you gotta become a secure party creditor, folks. We go to fidelity.com. The page you see should look like thus. What? The second thing you do, you see this tab in the upper left-hand corner, this text box? Right here? This screen right here, it changes. See how that screen keeps changing? Now, on the upper center of the screen, right? This tab right here, upper center, it says news and research. We click on that. That's how I got this to come up. I click on news and research. And I go down to quote. I click on that. I go to quotes. Boom. Brings me to that screen. That's the quote option. Now, at the top left, we see this text box. And in here, I would type whatever the court case, I'm not pulling up my birth certificate number, the birth certificate number, whatever. The birth certificate or Social Security number you would type in here. Or if you're looking up the CUSIP, the red CUSIP number on the back of the Social Security card in this box. Then once I type it there, I will click search. What? You guys could do this on your own later if you choose to. Well, and I'm making sure I'm searching in like a mutual fund that's on the stocks tab, as you see right there. Click on the search button. I write down the CUSIP number. Then I go back. It's going to pull up something when I do a search. Then I go back to the previous purge, and then I go to the search again. May take a few minutes, may have to wait. You're going to be directed back to a page that allows you to put the CUSIP number in the search box. Oh, yeah. If you do this on your own, you'll see that it pulls it up. Press go. So what appears in the next page, it says bond results. And so near the middle of the page, you will have two options. One is for contact or to call a rep who could explain questions about the bond. Birth certificate bond it is, right? You could click on the call the rep to get the phone number. The next one would tell you who's holding the bond. You click on that option, and below is a description. What about the bond details? It would tell you whether the bond is annual or not. It would tell you the maturity date, which is when the payment on the bond or the IOU is due, and whether there is a core protection. And yes, on a core protection means you cannot call in on the bond if you are old. The Social Security bonds will always say this because they cannot collect until maturity, which is retirement, a disability. Anyone in the movement of secure party creditors that's giving you advice that you could cash in on this bond is going to get you in trouble. It's telling you to go and take money out of an account is going to get you in trouble. They're going to cause you lawful problems. Might I also add, Social Security bonds are not marginable, which means they cannot draw a line of credit off of them because that is what the debtor does. That is what the United States Debtor Corporation is doing, is drawing a line of credit off of you through its international obligations secured by Article 6 of the Constitution, the 14th Amendment, and other statutes and codes that make you a subject. So anyone that's telling you any kind of card is a credit card is a damn fool. Understand that. So you cannot write signed drafts based on the federal government. Now you can do a rescission or cancellation of contract. Why would you want to? Now, when you're looking up this birth certificate on Fidelity, on the birth certificate, to see if they're trading on it, you go right here to the fidelity.com, click on the research right here. Well, you type in the birth certificate number, the first three numbers, then a dash, then the next two numbers, then a dash, and then the final numbers, and make sure the top two areas says mutual fund. Hmm? So you do your search and you find out who's trading on the fund for the birth certificate. And the next thing you do is you click on the initiated trading company name. Right? And that will give you all the trading information about who's trading on that fund that the birth certificate is part of. And so this document was essentially created when you was an infant. And commercial law allows for you to cancel and rescind this simple contract, UCC 3-203, and to make a claim and recoupment. What? UCC 3-305. The next, if you want to look up a court case, you could look up a court case. You type in the court case number of the federal, state, or municipal court case, and you could find out who owns the marginal line of credit on the annual bond of the federal, state, and municipal entities. Proven that all of these, or everything's monetized. See, a CUSIP number will appear, which tells you that the bond is on record with a clearinghouse agency of the federal government. Well, most likely the DTC, the Depository Trust Clearing Corporation, DTCC, or one of its subsidiaries. Now, after you get the case, click on the symbol to see who's doing the present trading. If you want to look up letters to credit, go to techagreement.com or the UCC office of each one of the 50 states and the District of Columbia or your local county recorder section. See, brothers and sisters, all letters of credit are government governed terms of these letters of credit by themselves. They're governed by terms of letters of credit. Article 5 of the Uniform Commercial Code. As UCC 5. You go and look up your letters of credit there. So how do we get out of all of this? How do we stop them from trading on the bond? Consumer credit? No. Equity? No. So how do we stop it? We stop it by becoming a secure party creditor. Thanks for the donation.